I've always wondered why Vegito and Gogeta are so damn popular in Dragon Ball in general, and I addressed this question in the video I did with Anime Balls Deep regarding the top 10 facts about Vegito that you maybe probably didn't know. Link in the description down below, check it out, I put a lot of hard work into that. But the point is, and this is more so a community response from the comments on that video, as well as my own thoughts, and many people did say that it's a combination of their favorite characters being Goku and Vegeta, the main two focal points at that point during the series, Goku and Vegeta. Now here's one thing to consider. Remember that Goku wasn't half as annoying or didn't get half as much hate as he did at that point, because during Dragon Ball Z, not only was the general fan base younger, they were a little bit more naive, and we weren't overexposed to him, although we kind of were, as we were in Dragon Ball Super. Look at Dragon Ball Super, everyone's complaining, Goku always gets the kill, but that's also adding the fact that in Dragon Ball Z, the characters at the time, we were happy with Gohan because of the fact that he had his ultimate form, he had his time to shine. We were happy with Vegeta, he redeemed himself from being a stupid idiot by unleashing Majin Buu onto the world. So when Goku and Vegeta fused together in Dragon Ball Z and they made Vegito, we were happy with Goku, we were happy with Vegeta, bang, wow, we saw Vegito, he was absolutely amazing and very similar to Fusion Reborn. We were happy with Goku, we were happy with Vegeta, he was dead still, he redeemed himself, and they made Gogeta, he looks absolutely amazing. Whereas in Dragon Ball Super, look, Gohan has been nerfed to a sense where it's absolutely humiliating. I don't care, I'm happy with him being a dad, but give him something important to do. And the thing with the Vegeta is the fact that because Vegeta has shown a lot of development and been given a combination of funny and badass moments, we need to have him on the same pedestal as Goku, who has been shoved down our throat. So we're not as happy with the characters right now that are being portrayed in Dragon Ball Super as we are in Dragon Ball Z. So it was a different time, and we were really happy during Dragon Ball Z, whereas in Dragon Ball Super we're a bit more cynical, stupid, and that's also due to the fact that we've had a decade or so to mature, to digest Dragon Ball. And here's the thing, Vegito or Gogeta have never been tested to the maximum. You could say, oh, in Dragon Ball Super episode 66, he was tested against Fusion Zamasu. No, he wasn't, because of the fact that the Fusion was cut short for some stupid reason. So Vegito, Super Gogeta and Gogeta Super Saiyan 4, as well as Vegito Super Saiyan Blue, have never ever been tested to the fullest. Look, Gogeta Super Saiyan 4 was having a laugh, he was playing around with Omega Shenron, and we know that Super Vegito was toying around with Buhan. The point is, he's never been tested, Gogeta's never been tested, and that's the absolute intrigue and mystique surrounding Gogeta and Vegito. This is what is fueling the what if battles. What if Gogeta were to verse Beerus? What if Gogeta were to verse so and so? And although many of these battles are a bit weird and a bit stupid, for example, what if Super Gogeta were to verse Beerus? We know that Beerus would win, and we also do know that, and yes, I did touch upon this on the facts video regarding Vegito, Gogeta is weaker than Vegito. But the point is, because Gogeta has not been written canonically into the series, we don't know, it's completely up in the air. So there's no point arguing who is stronger, Gogeta or Vegito, but there is intrigue and there is interest regarding who would win, Vegito Super Saiyan Blue or Beerus, who would win, Gogeta Super Saiyan 4 or Whis. Listen, you could speak about that, you can discuss that all you want, but the point is, this is one of the reasons why it's so interesting, because they've never been tested. Another reason why I think Gogeta and Vegito are so damn popular is the fact that it's an amalgam, it's a combination, it's a merge of those two personalities, and this is shown by the dual voice that we hear. We see Vegeta and Goku's voice, it's an overlay of their voice, and that's very, very unique. The last time we see something similar is, you know, when you have an evil villain and they echo their voice, similar to Omega, oh Goku, like, I don't know, something along the lines. But this was done very weirdly, because we had the two voice actors talk at the same time, and it adds a layer of personality. And let's talk about personality, because of the personality merging, they show this cock, it's just pure, it's like the absolute Saiyan who's also an absolute good guy, the good guy in terms of he wants to do good, but at the same time he wants to fight. We have cockiness, but as well as pure intelligence. Cockiness in terms of Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, Vegito was not cocky, he was very smart, he was antagonizing Buhan to infuriate him so that he can free Goten, Trunks, as well as Piccolo, and Gohan within Majin Buu. So that's a common misconception. I did address that in the Vegito video. But regarding the fact that it's a combination of the personality, that's another reason why people really did love Vegito and Gogeta. Because you don't have to choose between Goku and Vegeta. You don't have to say why Goku's better than Vegeta or Vegeta's better than Goku. We can just say, hey, Vegito, hey, Gogeta. And here's another reason why people are so damn interested and why I do think it's really popular. Because of the fact that, you know, when Goku said fusion, when he spoke about fusion, then we saw Gotenks in his Metamori's outfit, you know, that little waistcoat thingy and those puffy parachute pants, etc. We wondered, and I wondered, and you wondered, what if Goku and Vegeta did fusion? And they answered it, but they tried to one-up us by giving us Vegeta using the Potara earrings. But they answered a question with a completely different answer. But at the same time, we were happy with the answer because we still got fusion. But at the same time, we always wondered, what if they did finger fusion? What if Goku and Vegeta done fusion, huh? What would they look like? And then when we saw Gogeta, wow, he looked amazing. He looks better, in my opinion, than Vegeta. I like Vegeta as a character in every single way, except for the fact that I have to concede that Gogeta looks far superior as a character. And another thing about Gogeta, please stay on the lookout, check out Anime Balls Deep's channel. I'm gonna be doing a facts video around Gogeta soon, so that's in the works right now. It's kind of difficult, to be honest. The point is, they never answered the question of finger fusion for Vegeta and Goku. We got Vegeta instead. If I were to summarize, it's the merge of the two characters which people adore. The look is absolutely amazing. And from the merge, you have the personality. It's the fact that we never really saw them tested, so the unlimited potential. Another reason could be, in Budokai 3, if I recall correctly, Vegeta had a lot of key bars, whereas Gogeta had unlimited key bars. So there was a misconception. And this is where it stems from what, who is stronger, Gogeta or Vegito? It doesn't matter, because the truth is it's Vegito, but it really doesn't matter because of the fact that, hey, one of them, we haven't even seen him in the canonical universe, so how they write him is still up in the air. So there's no point arguing. The design looks absolutely phenomenal. That's my summary of why I think that Gogeta and Vegito are so damn popular. Please tell me why you think they're popular, how they could rectify or write in Gogeta into Dragon Ball Super. Who didn't fight? Who looks better? What's your favorite character between Vegito and Gogeta? Please make sure to check out the other videos, and please do like, share, and subscribe. I'm trying to grow as much as possible. You may now exit Dimps's domain. Thank you and goodbye.